Here is a story that Jesus told one day. One day, a farmer went out to plant some seeds. The farmer walked over his field and threw handfuls of seed onto the ground. Some of the seed landed near the road, and the birds came and gobbled it all up. Some of the seed landed on hard, rocky ground. That seed was able to grow, but when the hot sun came out, the plants dried up because the ground was too hard for the roots to go down deep where the water was. Some of the seed landed in with the weeds, and the weeds took all the water and good plant food from the dirt so that these plants died too. Poor plants. But some seed landed on good dirt where there were no rocks and no weeds. Those seeds grew up into strong, healthy plants that gave back 100 times more seeds to grow more plants with. After Jesus told this story, he also told what the story really meant. So I will too. The farmer is like God, and the seeds are the words of God, the good news about how to get to heaven. The ground is like people who hear the words of God. Some people are like the ground near the road. They hear the words, but the devil, who is like the birds in the story, takes the words away before the people can think about them and believe. Maybe they don't understand the words, or someone tells them that they are not true. Some people are like the ground with all the rocks. They hear the good news and are happy to believe it right away. But as soon as it gets hard to be a friend of Jesus, like if they are asked to help at church or if they don't get the answer they want to a prayer, they stop believing. Some people are like the ground with weeds. There are so many other things in their lives that they can't pay attention to Jesus. The other things, like the weeds in the story, get all their attention, and so, even though they still believe in Jesus, they don't live like he would want them to. But some people are like the good soil. They hear the word of God and believe it and study it and do everything they can to be more like Jesus. They make him the most important person in their lives and tell other people about Jesus too. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. It's your turn to sing with me. Come on. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. God is alive, and this is how I know, because he lives in my heart. The Bible tells me so. The Bible tells me so.